Starlink, the satellite internet constellation operated by SpaceX, was set up to deliver satellite internet connectivity to the vast majority of the world's population. To be fully operational, the company projects require the deployment of 12,000 satellites, and with a manufacturing rate of about 120 satellites per month, conservative estimates put the earliest this could be complete at mid-2027. As expected, the constellation continues to grow, and by January 6, 2022, about 2,000 flat-paneled Starlink satellites had already been deployed. While the idea of global internet connectivity might seem plausible, astronomers, and specifically stargazers, have raised the flag on how this light pollution could ruin the night sky and possible ways to mitigate, if any, the effects. Is having another source of internet worth losing access to unobstructed stargazing? As of December 2021, Starlink, a SpaceX division, provided internet service to 21 countries. The company's origins can be traced back to 2014, with heavy network construction beginning in 2015. In 2018, the prototype satellites were sent into orbit from launch sites such as Vandenberg Space Force Base in California, Cape Canaveral Space Force Station, and John F. Kennedy Space Center. Within the same year, the FCC gave clearance for 12,000 Starlink satellites to be deployed, and a further 30,000 active satellites in orbit to follow. If successful, this would form the Starlink mega constellation. This means over 3,000 active satellites in orbit. Contemporary Starlinks are brighter than 99% of them due to their lower orbits, greater proximity to Earth's surface, and more reflectivity than what Starlink developers had initially projected. This, plus the idea of other companies also joining in, doesn't seem to go down well with stargazers, both professional and amateur. To begin with, it is important to understand that if one was stargazing the night sky with the unaided eye from a dark sky area, there is a possibility of them seeing about 4,500 stars. This number reduces when they move to a suburban location to about 400. Additionally, some simulations have shown that when compared to the number of visible stars after sunset and before morning, hundreds of starlinks will be visible. Previously, light pollution in stargazing could be solved by leaving the suburban areas for rural areas. Unfortunately, the satellites are a global cluster phenomenon and cannot be solved by this. The second reason is the crowding of the night sky. This factor is exacerbated by the fact that even if SpaceX reconfigures its intentions, other firms are already actively creating mega constellations, and there are more in the works. Currently, the only law that is in place internationally only enforces the cleaning up of any mess left on the surface of Earth after crashing. This means that if there was a satellite collision in their orbits, no country is obligated to help clean up the debris. Certainly, because there are no regulations for cleaning up satellite debris, most of it remains in orbit. Thousands of pieces of space trash, ranging in size from bolts to bus-sized dead satellites, have been discovered. Unquestionably, SpaceX has tried to mitigate some of these events that threaten to ruin the night sky. Elon Musk has defended Starlink from the claim that it is clogging up space. He argued that currently, only under 1,900 satellites had been deployed, and there is still enough extraterrestrial space in the low Earth orbit for competitors. Further, even though it can still ruin astronomers' data, SpaceX has darkened its Starlink internet satellites with visors to avoid disrupting the night sky. This means that Starlink may be nearly invisible to the human eye at this point. The addition of new sun visors to the most recent 415 satellites launched by SpaceX may have darkened them significantly. After launch, the visors deploy and prevent sunlight from shining off the satellite's brightest surfaces. These visorsats have succeeded in making the satellites less reflective, but it's still visible from dark sky areas. Therefore, for the time being, the Starlink satellites will be a source of distraction for stargazers, but the visorsats are a major improvement. Also, it will be interesting to see if and how other satellite providers notice and follow suit. If you like this video, please consider subscribing and click the notification bell so you do not miss any upcoming videos.